MIT is working on creating the Kinect sensor of the future, which can see through walls using simple radio waves. The very early proof of concept uses three radio antennas, two transmitting and one receiving, and could place a person on the other side of a wall within 10 centimeters of accuracy. At MIT's Computer Science and Artificial Laboratory, or CSAIL, a person could walk around a room while being tracked, which is represented by the red dot on the screen. The marks on the floor were only to show how accurate the system is. Being able to track users so accurately presents a number of different uses for the technology.
So this is one aspect of it, which is virtual reality and gaming. And the other aspect, which we think is also very important, is localization. So today there's a huge interest in localization. Can you localize a person using radio signals? And there has been a lot of advancements in, say, Wi-Fi based localization, which require you to actually hold a transmitter. But what we're doing here is that we're doing localization through a wall without requiring you to hold any transmitter or receiver, simply by using reflections off a human body. And what is very impressive about this is that our accuracy is even higher than state-of-the-art Wi-Fi localization systems.
One of the drawbacks of the system right now is that it can only track one person at a time, and the rest of the area needs to be completely clear of movement. If two people are standing in the room like I was with my camera, I needed to remain relatively still so the system wouldn't get confused.
Another aspect we are working on and hoping to get is, now it's mostly tracking if a person is moving. If a person stops, then it will interpolate his location, and so it will know that it is in his same location. What if the device starts even when a person is just standing and breathing? And so we actually now have an initial algorithm that can even tell us, even if a person is just standing and breathing, pinpoint his location.
Adib also said the system allows for 3D tracking and could be useful in telling when someone has fallen in their home. In addition to tracking multiple people at once, the team is also working on making the system a bit more compact.
We can put a lot more work into miniaturizing the hardware. The antennas don't need to be as far apart as they are now. We actually can bring these closer together to the size of a Kinect, possibly smaller, and in the process lose a little bit of accuracy, but compared to the gains that our system provides, it's minimal.
The group filed a patent just this week, and while there are no immediate plans for commercialization, team members were speaking with representatives from major wireless and component companies during the CSAIL open house. At MIT in Cambridge, Nick Barber, IDG News Service.